Are you amplified on these flutes here now?
I don't want any. That's... Now, once more. Very light in the EX, the 42. Very light.
The acid test. For the first time, a composer can hear the results of a labor that may have taken days or weeks or months.
Marty?
Jerry Goldsmith is conducting his own work for the Mephisto Waltz. His past is laced with scores for Patton and Tora, Tora, Tora and the Sand Pebbles.
Look, can you start the flute softer, much slighter?
From the depth of him has come music for more than 50 theatrical films and a host of TV shows. But there still is, and there always may be, that feeling.
Butterflies and all the apprehensions. The nervousness, the anticipation, and the worry is it okay? Is it right? Is it wrong? I can't sleep the night before. My stomach's upset. I sweat. Because I spent a lot of time creating it, I want it to be right for the screen.
Much less of it.
Facing the orchestra is the moment of truth. Now we hear whether it is good, bad, or indifferent. And on the Mephisto Waltz, I wasn't quite sure about how many things would sound because there were a combination of instruments I'd never put together before. I had anticipated what they would sound like. I heard the sound, but I couldn't be sure of it because there was so much electronic amplification and a lot of electrical instruments.
Could I get in bar 29, Hal? A little sharper on a rim shot. It sounds like a little flat. That's fine. Let me the snare drum and the two together. Both of you together. That's what I want, yeah.
Get the rim shot right.
The
performance is 50% of it all. I can only put my ideas on paper.
Here we go. Come on. Shh.
And then I'm at the mercy of the people who play it.
Keep it up. Did you play everything already at that time? Did you play everything? That's all. That was good. That was good. Let's see you do it again. That was good. Doesn't make a damn bit of difference.
All right. 29, here we go.
Good. Keep it up. Clicks and just see what it looks like. Or...
Everybody, put your headsets on.
Stand by, I'm gonna roll. Keep your eyes.
I may have it too cluttered up in there. I don't know.
Wait to see what.
Okay. Roll it. One. Two.
Very difficult. You can't expect that, even though these are marvelous musicians, for them to sit down as an entire unit and play a perfectly balanced, perfect performance to my specifications the first time through. takes a lot of patient work with never enough time to do it in because the clock is ticking. And that's a very expensive proposition when you have an orchestra of 55 or 60 musicians and to sit there and woodshed over one bar. And yet, as an artist, one has a feeling of professionalism and perfection. So it satisfies the requirements of the drama.
Now, Louis, now, 38.
Take $10.
So we must rehearse.
1, 2, da-da-dee-da. 1, 2, da-da-dee-da.
It's a tedious job, but the end results are reward enough for the effort put in.
Right here. It's 6-8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah, but there's still one of these chairs. It looks like a 9-8 program.
There's not. Just like 2 8th notes, 2 16th make notes, make 3 8th notes. Dee dum dee. Da dee dee dum dee dum dee dum dee da da da. 1, 2, da da dee da dee da dee da dee da.
I've written an entirely original score for this film, but yet I paraphrased Liszt. Mephisto Waltz was about a group of people who were doing business with the devil, and the open strings is the way Liszt depicts the devil, Mephistopheles, tuning his instrument. And I took that little bit out of the actual waltz and trying to relate in the picture the forces of good and evil. Lionel Newman, the head of the music department at 20th Century Fox, he has the unpleasant task of keeping it within the framework of a certain budget. His responsibility, of course, is to the producers, to the studio, to recommend to them who he thinks is the best for the job. And they've always liked me. I love him.
It comes in and takes over here, too. On the sea, it takes over the sea. Oh, it does?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, they're an octave above you, though. Yeah.
And this scores the first minor second you're asking about. Tell me, if you had D flat, would it have made a difference? If you had a D flat, would you have asked the question? Oh, change the D flat.
Gosh.
He's your friend.
I just inherited it.
Bar 70.
What friend?
1, 2.
Hard on Louis. He's a great concert violinist. Here I was reducing him to very simple, almost student-like things to play, and yet asking a certain interpretation of it, which is very difficult because we do unorthodox things now. We don't play on the strings. We play between the bridge and the tailpiece. And it's just, sometimes the violinists always laugh about something like that. It's virtually just tuning up the instrument. It is terribly important that one be very serious about this because it's a very dramatic and important part of the score.
140. That's too... Hold it. That's too much on the organ. There's much, much less than it. Very subtle.
You know, just a color, not a...
Let me go back and pick it up from the walls.
That's the whole payoff.
I recorded for 3 days in this picture.
It's really got a...
This film had a lot of music because much of what had to be said wasn't in the script, it wasn't in the action. This whole supernatural process that was occurring had to be somehow conveyed in the language of music.
Come on, keep up! Now! Crescendo.
any. Now, this is one spot, and see if you get any violas here, and we'll make it. This is bar 156.
That was so shocked by the fact that this whole collage of sound, this whole mixed up crazy sick sound had come out of my mind.
All right, Vin?
Yeah, I know.
Let's make it.
Any little help will be appreciated.
You know I aim to be helpful.
I know how helpful you can be, Jerry.
I'm one of the most helpful of all helpful people.
You are a budget buster.
I haven't busted a budget in a long time.
Not since the last picture.
I did very well in Torah.
I'm giving you two takes to do this.
G69 has 177 to 78.
This is it.
This is it. One. Two.
Should have been a take.
What's that?
Perfect.
You're back.
Put your bows away, but not your violin. That should be it.
That should be it. Thank you all very much.
Bravo, bravo.
Okay, 3 days of blood, believe me.
The challenge of writing for motion pictures is the ever unending pressure that is constantly upon you as an artist.
Shelley's got the bottom.
The drive to keep fresh, alive, and to progress. It's too easy to become settled in your ways and your successes and your laurels. But it's much more exciting to keep inventing new ideas, developing new ideas, looking for new paths. So with all the complaining we do and the lack of time, the lack of understanding, it's still it's an opportunity to express ourselves that few composers that have preceded this era have ever had.
Oh, it's perfect. Just marvelous. Now you've just got a spiel.
I got a hand.
All these dynamics.
Yeah, I got it.
When you're working on it. Just
growing as a creator. That's what is exciting. Not what I do.
Bring that sweeper check way down.
And the first recording is a strange, terrible letdown. I spent an awful lot of my life, 6 weeks, 2 months, pouring it into this particular project.
You have to get Kurt through a little bit better.
The emotional.
Yeah, there's an extra thing in there.
Excitement, the whole joy of creativity is now gone. After the scoring stage, you go into the dubbing, it's the mechanics, your creativity reduced to being an accompanying factor to the dialogue, the sound effects, the varying whims of the producer, the director, the technicians, everybody who had an opinion now of how the music should be treated. It always happened in the dubbing stage. You're fair prey to everyone.
Here, we're going to pick it up from here, Jerry, just to see if we can't get a nice...
Well, I got to eliminate something here.
You want to go back farther?
No, this is fine.
By now, the music cutter is prepared in the tracks that contain the music so that they will synchronize with the rest of the film.
All right, now at this point, now kill a
creak
attack.
Here he comes.
All right. Your sweetness too heavy. Still too heavy.
Okay. Now. How about that?
Bring up your orchestra a little bit. If you can.
Essentially, what we're doing is adding all the elements, sound, music, and dialogue, into one track. You have a mixer for the music, you have a mixer for the sound effects, and you have a mixer for the dialogue. Each man's function is to blend with the other so that there's a total composite effect in the end. But we go over and over certain scenes to get the balance of sound and dialogue and music before making a composite track. And sometimes we can spend as much as a whole day on doing 10 minutes of a picture. Mephisto Waltz, I think we spent almost 2 working weeks dubbing this film. Sweetener tracks that were done by slowing down the tape or recording certain musical effects backwards, and those are superimposed over the actual orchestra recording. Since the music has been recorded on 6 different tracks, percussion are on 1 track, the woodwinds are another track, the strings are somewhere else, pianos are somewhere else, I can rebalance the music according to what the demands are on the screen.
That's good.
In the case of Mephisto Waltz, the producer, Quinn Martin, was present the whole time. He happens to be a very sympathetic man towards music. And it afforded me the opportunity of spending a great deal of time trying things that normally wouldn't happen in a picture. It even went so far as to eliminate some dialogue so that it wouldn't obscure the structure of the music.
So that's natural.
Yeah, that you did that.
I did that. That's right.
Right. Make you happy, Jerry?
Was everybody happy? Me? What have you?
I mean, you're the.
But it's a fit for me.
Oh, God, it's beautiful.
I thought it was excellent. Yeah, good.
Boy, we have to ask the one important person here, Kenny Womberg.
Yes. What's the question?
No, say no. Say no.
Oh, head, gentlemen, what's the number, please? Are you happy with everything on your end?
Yeah.
I thought we got everything out of it.
Yeah.
Well, it came out very good, Clint. He has a proper amount of.
Menace, and yet it's sensuous.
Good.
And I happen to be pretty on top of it all.
Yeah, I'm kidding.